下面这段蓝色的是一个解释。The towering steep is again the ramparts. The bombardment has failed, and the British can do nothing more but sail away. Their mission a failure. 研究明白了。In the third stanza, I feel, 就这个故事的作者啊，这个 In the third stanza, I feel he allows himself to gloat over the American triumph. In the aftermath, 对英军的失败，他是幸灾乐祸啊。In the aftermath of the bombardment, Key probably was in no mood to act otherwise. 也许他没有在这样的一个情形下没有办法表达别的思想，只能是对英军幸灾乐祸啊。During World War I, when the British were our staunchest allies, the third stanza was not sung. However, I know it, so here it is.一战的时候呢，英国是我们的盟友，所以第三段呢就不唱了，因为第三段是讽刺英军的啊，讽刺英军的，所以就不唱了。但是我知道这段还是唱出来。看第三段是什么 ？And where is that band who so vauntingly swore that the havoc of war and the battle's confusion?A home and a country should leave us no more. 这个顺序跟我们平时说话的顺序不一样，我们要破解一下啊。And where is that band? Band 是指什么呢 ？A group of persons living outside the law. 梁山好汉啊，一群土匪啊。A renegade band. 所以这里边的 band 是指英军。Where is that band? 那群土匪在哪里现在 ？Who so vauntingly to speak boastfully of, brag about? 啊，很嚣张的，自负的。Who so vauntingly swore? 这英军曾经发誓 that the havoc of war and the battle's confusion.Should leave us no more home and no more country, no more home and no more country. 这是它的结构。The havoc of war, 战争的破坏和战斗的混乱将使我们啊丧失，将摧毁我们的这个家园，摧毁我们的国家。Their blood.Has washed out their foul steps pollution. Their blood 这句话也是很费解啊，我也是查了很多东西才理解。等会儿我再看一看查的资料。Their blood 他们的血，英军的血 has washed out 冲掉了 their foul footsteps pollution 他们那臭脚印的。污秽污染，这是个比喻的啊，比喻的说法。No refuge could save the hireling and slave from the terror of flight or the gloom of the grave. No refuge 没有任何一个避难之处 could save the hireling.通过资料显示 ，hireling 是指雇佣兵 ，and slave 是指为英军打仗的黑奴。英军承诺战后给他们自由。No refuge 没有任何一个避难地方可以救那些雇佣兵和那些黑奴。从什么地方救他们呢 ？From the terror of flight.逃跑的恐惧 or the gloom of the grave 啊，阴暗的坟墓，没有人能够从空气当中成就他们，是指成就这些啊英军 战士，英军的士兵。And the star-spangled banner in triumph does wave over the land of the free and home of the brave. 又再次重复，我们的旗帜确实还在飘扬，看清楚了，确实还在飘扬。Does wave 用的是现在时 ，does wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave。第四段 ，the fourth stanza, a pious hope for the future， 展望未来 ，should be sung more slowly than the other three， and with even deeper feeling。Oh, thus be it ever, when free men shall stand between their loved homes and their wars and the war's desolation. Thus be it ever, ever be it ever always, when free men shall stand. 这个语法上可能不是太容易理解 ，be it ever。就是 be it ever, be whatever. 希望什么成为永远呢？我的理解是后边这个 when 啊 ，when free men shall stand between their loved homes， 在他们可爱的家乡 ，and the war's desolation 和残酷的战争之间，我们自由人要站在这个可爱的家乡和家园和战争之间，也就是说，我们自由的人呢要去保护。保卫我们的家园，免受战争的破坏，我想是应该是这个意思啊。Blessed with victory and peace, may the heaven rescued land. The heaven rescued land 被上天成就的国家 ，praise the power that has made and preserved us a nation. 我们既然是被上帝拯救了，我们。就要赞扬、赞美 the power。the power 是指什么呢 ？the God 啊 ，the God that has made 创造 and preserved us a nation 和保存我们这个民族的力量。Then conquer we must。conquer 就是 be victorious。Then conquer we must。那我们一定能够取胜。Then we must conquer。For our cause is just， 因为我们的事业是正义的啊。And this be our motto， 这是我们的啊这个 motto 座右铭。In God is our trust， we trust in God。And the star-spangled banner in triumph does wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave。I hope you will look at the national anthem with new eyes， listen to it。And the next time you have a chance with new ears, pay attention to the words and don't let them ever take it away. Not even one word of it. 这是那篇文章。这篇文章尽管非常简短，但它解释的非常清楚。那这个刚才我提了疑问，这个旗帜fly over the rampart， 它在什么地方飘扬？它在那个城墙的上空飘扬，它不是插在城墙上的。我通过其他的资料、图片啊，最后我等会儿还会向大家这个展示一个视频的片段，你们看到这个旗帜呢，它不是插在城墙上，更不是碉堡上啊，它只是从远处。啊，看到城墙上空飘扬着旗帜，具体插在什么地方我们也可能不知道，可能是室内一个很高的建筑上。这个 stream 呢，字典上解释 a continuous flow of liquid or gas， 还有我参照了美国儿童美国历史，给儿童讲美国历史的，能了解到当时两人滞留在船上的原因。比如说 ，The two were detained on the ship so as not to warn the Americans while the Royal Navy attempted to bombard Fort McHenry， 就是我刚才所说的啊。两个人呢，暂时被这个滞留在英军的船上。 我在网上还看到有些美国的历史老师把前两段歌词翻成了现代英文，也帮助我对这个歌词有了进一步的了解。这我刚才讲 Where the foe's haughty host in dread silence reposes 这句话我最初没有理解，对我不知道这个 where 修是谁。那么看到了这人的翻译啊，我这个认识到这个 where 呢是修饰那个 the deep the ocean 的啊。下面是现代英文的翻译，大家看一下。One of the problems for modern readers, especially young ones, may be the language used. Poetry is often hard for some people to understand, and the language of this verse is a bit archaic. So I thought I'd do a little exercise in modernization. If the Star-Spangled Banner were written today, how would it be expressed? Here is my rendition of how a young person today might express this situation. It's not exactly poetry, but it might help young readers understand the meaning of the words.Oh, tell me, please. Can you see what we are looking for in the light of the dawn? The flag we were watching by the last light of last night, with its broad stripes and bright stars, that through all the danger of the battle, we could still see over the walls of the fort, waving so gallantly in the breeze.他后面没有用问句，我觉得他翻的这个也不一定很对啊。我等会儿还会向大家展示理解更离谱的美国人啊。And all through the night, the rockets and the bombs lighting up the sky told us what we needed to know, that our flag was still flying there. But please, oh please tell me, is the Star-Spangled Banner the one that still waves over?The land of the free and the home of the brave. Over there on the shore, hardly seen through the misty haze from the water, the deep, where the ship of this arrogant enemy waits in dreadful silence. What is it that the breeze is blowing over the towering cliff are partly concealing and partly disclosing? Look now.It's catching the gleam of the first rays of sunshine, and the light is reflecting the full glory of its colors. 这句话理解的不太对的啊。And the light reflected glory, 就是这个旗帜因美军的取胜而带上了荣耀，但是这儿他说的是 the light is reflecting the full glory of its colors, 说它的颜色。It's the star-spangled banner, yes, long.May it wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave. 他只翻了两段，但是两段呢，有的地方我认可，有的地方我认为他的理解不太对。这是一个教历史的美国老师啊。我们再看一看这个维基百科里边啊，也有帮我有些地方帮我澄清的问题啊。其中这个 "Free man shall stand between" 这句话。Oh, thus be it ever when free men shall stand between their loved homes and war's desolation. There was a, 这是 wiki 上的一点内容。There was a two-year debate in the proceedings of the Institute of the 21st Century Studies that was sparked by a comparison between a quote in Starship Troopers and the noblest fate, Troopers, that the noblest fate that a man can endure is to place his own mortal body between his loved home and war's desolation. 这是Starship Troopers 当中的一句话 paraphrase of the fourth stanza of the Star-Spangled Banner. 那么这句话呢是对国歌当中这句话的解释啊 and the anti-war poem Duels at Dagram Est by Wilfred Owen. 那这句话我不理解，但是看到有人解释这句话，那就让我对这句话有了比较清楚的认识。The noblest fate of a man, 一个人最崇高的事情呢，就是能够为国捐躯， 回国前去 to place his mortal body between his loved home and war's desolation. 还有一段话 In a commentary on his essay, Who are the heirs of Patrick Henry? Heinlein agreed that Starship Troopers glorifies the military, specifically the PBI, the poor bloody infantry, the mudfoot who places his frail body between his loved home and the war's desolation, but is rarely appreciated. He has the toughest job of all and should be honored. 还看到一点也很有意思啊，国旗的保存。The nature of the possible battle damage to the flag varies among witnesses and has led historians to theorize that there were actually two flags present at Fort McHenry. 就这个旗帜它飘在上空是不是被那个炸弹啊炸坏了，因为后来有一个旗说是在那个战场上取下来的，是比较完整的啊。A smaller one, which was, 当时所以有人就认为是挂了两面旗啊。A smaller one, which was flown during the actual battle, and a larger one that was flown as a replacement immediately after the British retreat. 就是有人认为，当时挂了一面小旗，后来打完了之后又把那小旗换下来，换成一个大旗。This was a common wartime practice of the period. 因为那个打仗的时候呢，旗帜很可能被打得破烂不堪啊，剩了之后赶紧换一个新的。While no one can say for sure what really happened, documents exist that show that Mary Pickergill was paid for two separate flags. 就是这个做旗子的这个人呢，这个裁缝啊，他拿了两个旗的钱，那很可能他做了两个旗啊，做了两个旗。A small one and a larger one. If the smaller flag exists, its whereabouts are unknown. 如果那小旗存在的话，也不知道现在在哪里的。现在博物馆里保存的是那个大旗。我在这个其他文章里边还看到，这个旗帜呢，在存放在某一个地方的当年呢，去参观的人呢，可以拿小剪刀剪下一块做留念啊。后来去参观的人太多了，这剪的这个旗越来越短，后来就不让再剪了。我还查了一些电子地图啊，电子地图来帮助我理解当时的这个战况。这就是刚才大家看到了。马里兰州啊，巴尔的摩市的位置啊，这是更近一点的图。英军从这个地方靠近巴尔的摩，从这个海湾，这是巴尔的摩的近视图。这就是 Fort McHenry 美军把守的一个地方。那这个歌词的翻译啊，这是我修改的，我翻的啊，根据别人的翻译来修改的。我把它这样翻译了一下，它称不上诗歌，我不会写诗啊，所以这是直白的意思。哦，我说你看见了吗？就着黎明的曙光，这黎明的微光。夜幕降临前，我们还自豪地向他致敬。我们曾见那宽阔的条纹、明亮的星星，在危险的战斗中勇敢地飘扬在城墙上空，耀眼的火光、隆隆的炮声。证明在整个晚上我们的旗帜还岿然不动，这不一定合适啊。你们谁有文采可以将来就着我的再改一改啊。哦，我说那星光闪耀的旗帜还在飘扬吗？飘扬在自由的国土，勇者的家乡。傲慢的敌军战舰在死寂中沉睡，透过海上的迷雾隐约看到岸边，那高耸的城墙上在阵阵微风中若隐若现的是什么？他在早晨第一缕阳光的照射下迎风招展，闪烁着荣光。那是星条旗，哦，愿那星条旗永远飘扬在自由的国土，勇士的家乡。那帮土匪在哪里？他们扬言战争的破坏，战场的混乱，将使我们有家难回，有国难归。他们的血已经荡尽那臭脚留下的污秽，没有什么避难所可以让那些雇佣兵和奴隶摆脱逃亡的恐惧和坟墓的阴暗。那胜利的星条旗确实还在飘扬，飘扬在自由的国土，勇者的家乡。哦，自由的人们，永远不要让战争的废墟靠近心爱的家园。上天成就了祖国， 赐予我们胜利与和平，让我们赞美、创造和保存我们民族的力量。我们一定会胜利，因为我们是正义的事业，因为我们的事业是正义的。请永远牢记，我们信仰上帝。那胜利的信条旗确实还飘扬在自由的国土、勇者的家乡。那在我调查研究过程当中，我就发现啊，这首歌已经被很多人翻译过了啊。维基百科中文版里边就有它的译文，新华社也有它的译文啊，再加上这个台湾啊也有它的译文。那我们看看维基百科里边的译文。基本全错啊，Oh, can you see by the dawn's early light? Oh, 你们能否在黎明的第一道曙光里看到 ？What so proudly we hailed the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous flight over the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming? Oh, 你们能否在黎明的第一道曙光里看到我们与黄昏的最后一道光线中礼赞的荣耀？黄昏的最后一道光线。这个没错，礼赞的荣耀是什么意思？谁的阔条明星 ？Whose broad stripes？ 谁的阔条明星冒着一夜炮火，依然劲风招展？还是这个不知道是不是劲啊？我军碉堡上，我军碉堡上，这好像是一个军人讲的话。我军的碉堡上，火炮闪闪发光，炸弹轰轰作响，他们都是见证国旗安然无恙。这个意思也不算太错啊，他们都是见证，这个意思说得过去啊。合唱 ，Oh, does that star-spangled banner yet wave over the？ 你看那新条旗不是还高高飘扬在这自由的国土勇士的家乡，那它变了，变成了一个不是还，就是第一段就已经看见了，是不是？是错的，这句话的理解是错的。你看见了吗？第一段你看见了吗？他说你看那新条旗不是还高高飘扬在，这就错了。